Project-Chungking Express is directed by a Hong Kong director, Wong Kar-wai, who is also a producer and screenwriter. Chungking Express mainly talked about how two love stories happen, however, no development of both of the relationships afterwards. Even though it sounds disappointed to most of the audience, this film focuses on more interesting points that will never bore the audience. We can divide a film into two separate parts. The first part is the story about police 223 and a mysterious female drug dealer. The second part didn't expand the story of the previous part, and instead, it starts off another story of a different police, 663 and Faye, who is the cousin of the shop owner. Wong Kar-wai's distinctive storytelling is very different than the Hollywood style. He purposefully applied cinematography, mise-en-scène, editing, and sound techniques in this film to create a dynamic narration in a relatively flat plot. In the beginning sequence of the first part, the director veiled the complexity of interior structure and the potential danger in Chungking Mansion. First up, an Asian woman with unusual blonde hair and sunglasses shows up in the street. Her peculiar costume and actions in the street leaves a suspense in the audience's heart. Dutch angle. In this scene, the director manipulates cinematography techniques such as track shots and moving angles to create a distorted environment revealing the danger in the Chungking Mansion. And the two techniques also applies on the next scene, which PC-223 is chasing a criminal. When PC-223 is chasing a criminal in the street, the background music levels up the intensity of the environment. Just as Chiang's theories on sound, the background music shaped the narrative space. This background music in the first part of the story is a motive representing intense and serious situations. The two characters cross the paths, suggesting that all lives are intertwined at some point. In the next scene, a transition of which the conversation between PC-223 and the shop owner to the bar scene is purposeful, as it shows the distance between PC-223 and woman. Two separated scenes created a juxtaposition between the two main characters. In this scene, the woman is planning for her drug transportation plan, and here is a male gaze. From her male gaze, we can infer that the woman is desired to have a happy family and an ordinary life. Unlike the first story, in the second part, Faye and PC-663 have a development on their relationships. The house key in the envelope intrigues Faye to have an adventure in his apartment. A long tilt shot leads the audience to think ahead. The boiling coffee symbolizes Faye's feeling as which she cannot wait any minute. A quick zoom-in shot in Faye's plastic gloves reverses the audience's mood. The environment becomes more serious because of the zoom-in shot. The song California Dreamin' as a diegetic sound functions as a motive in this part as it reflects on Faye's dream, pursuit, and her adventurous passion. The song also connects to a character's life and it creates a dynamic narration other than characters' individual monologues. After Faye's first time cleaning up PC-663's home, her reflection on the mirror foreshadows her chill mood. In this scene, Faye accidentally meets with PC-663 by the door. She stays at his home because she cramps her ankle. Cinematography techniques constrains two characters in a Dutch angle in the mirror, suggesting their closer relationships. The application of cinematography in this part has a crucial impact on foreshadowing characters' attitudes to whatever the situation they are facing. PC63 lives in an environment that phase changes. As a result, he distracts from the previous relationship with the secret help from Faye. I found this part extremely interesting. And the monologue is exclusive Wong Kar-wai style. It is a great echoing sequence in response to Faye's action in the previous scene. Some similarities and differences in two parts. They have similar open endings which leave audience space to imagine. They both use blue as cool color tone and yellow as warm color tone. There are also some numbers illustrating how people easily get lost in modern society. For some point, the two parts seem to have no connection, but everything is deliberately set up by the director. Characters' actions take place at the same time in the film world, so it enhances a chaotic vibe in relation to sequences of events that seem accidental. In the beginning scene, the director tries to convey the gap between people subjected in the great distance of communication in a modern society. However, you will never know whether the person you pass by will become your best friend or your lover. Just as PC223 says in the beginning, we rub shoulders every day. We may not know each other, but we could be close friends someday. Police, stewardess, drug dealer and employee are some unstable occupations. The characters in the film don't have specific identity. The director also points out that those characters represent a group of people in an unstable society. The places such as bar, convenience shop, and fast food restaurant are also a representation for their unstable life and in a society. Those places symbolizes the characters' fast food love for one another, come and go instantly.